Good morning, students. This is class 10 science. Listen, light, reflection and reflection. Class, in continuation with the previous lecture, today we are going to study image formation by concave mirror. Image formation by concave mirror. See, first we'll study about object at focus. This is our concave mirror and we have placed the object AB at focus. Where we have placed the object? AB at focus. This is the object. This is the ray which is emerging from the head of the object. It is parallel to the principal axis and after reflection, it will pass through the focus. The next ray is passing undeviated through the center of curvature. Image will be formed at infinity. So we can say that when the object is at focus, image will form at infinity. Where will the image be formed? Image will be formed at infinity. So the position of image is at infinity. Size of the image, the image formed is much larger than the object. Image formed is much larger than the object. And nature of the image, real and inverted image will be formed. So I repeat, when the object is at focus, a real, inverted and enlarged image will be formed at infinity. Object at focus, image at infinity. Now the second is, when the object is at infinity. Object is at infinity. See, this is the object which is at infinity. Ray of light coming from the object passing parallel to the principal axis after reflection will pass through the focus. Another ray of light passing through the principal axis after reflection will pass through the focus. So these two rays, or rays may be as many as it can be, but for image formation, we require minimum two rays. So we are drawing ray diagram with two rays. The two rays are meeting at focus. So the image will be formed at focus. Image will be formed at focus. So we can say that when the object is at infinity, image will be formed at focus. And position of the image is at focus. Size of the image, it is very diminished, highly diminished or point size. Image formed is highly diminished or point size. And the nature of the image is real and inverted. Nature of the image is real and inverted. So I repeat, when the object is at infinity, image will be formed at focus. Image will be highly diminished or point size and real and inverted. Next position, when the object is at C, when the object is at C, C means object is at center of curvature. This is the AB is the object, a ray passing parallel to the principal axis after reflection will pass through focus, reach over here, another ray passing to the principal axis after reflection. One ray is passing parallel to the principal axis. After reflection is going through the focus. Another ray through focus after reflection will go parallel to the principal axis. Two rays from this A point parallel to the principal axis after reflection will pass through the focus. Another ray of from A pass through the focus after reflection will go parallel to the principal axis. It will meet over here. So the image will be formed at C. See, object at C, center of curvature, image is at C. Position of the image, at C. Nature of the image, it is also real and inverted. See, you can see the image is inverted. It is real. And size of the image, it is of the same size as that of the object. So I repeat, we can say when the object is at C, object is at center of curvature, Image will also be formed at center of curvature. The image formed will be of the same size, real and inverted. Next. When the object is beyond C, see, this is center of curvature, object is beyond C. Ray of light parallel to the principal axis after reflection passing through focus. Another ray of light passing through the center of curvature is retracing its own path. These two rays are meeting at point A. Image formed will be this, A dash and B dash, between center of curvature and focus. Between center of curvature and focus. You can also see the size of the image. The object is big, image is small. So we can say that when the object is far away from C or beyond C, image formed will be between center of curvature and focus. Center of curvature and focus, and the size of the image will be smaller than the object. It is smaller than the object and its nature is real and inverted. Next position. When the object, now we'll place the object between C and F, between center of curvature and, yes, object between C, object between C and F, center of curvature and focus. This AB is the object which is placed between center of curvature and focus. Now, ray of light will start from here, parallel to the principal axis, after reflection will pass through the focus. Then another ray of light starting from the ear, reflection passing through, ray of light coming from center of curvature after reflection will retrace its path. Both the rays are meeting at this point, B dash and A dash. Image is formed over here. So we can say that when the object is between center of curvature and principal focus, image is formed beyond C. Image is formed beyond C. Nature of the image, it is real and inverted. It is real and inverted. And size of the image, it is larger than the object. See, object is small and image is larger than the object. Followed. Now the last stage. See, up till now, we have studied that when the object is at focus, image formed will be at infinity. When the object is at infinity, image will be formed at focus. When the object is at center of curvature, image will formed at center of curvature. When the object is between C and F, image will be formed beyond C. And when the object is beyond C, image will be formed between C and F. Now, another position, when the object is placed between focus and pole, you can see over here. When the object is placed between focus and pole. See, this is the object, A and B. A ray of light going from here, retracing its path. Another making an angle, again making an angle. And if these two rays are brought backward, a virtual and erect image will be formed. Virtual and erect image will be formed behind the mirror, and it is larger or bigger than the object. This is the reason we say that concave mirror mostly forms real and erect image, but it can also form virtual and erect image when we move towards the mirror. See, the object is near the mirror. Is it clear to all of you? Should I repeat or is it clear? I think it is clear to all of you. So we'll conclude. These all ray diagrams are given in your NCRT. Object at infinity, image at focus. then object beyond C, object beyond C, image between C and F, center of curvature and focus. Object at C, images at C. Object between center and focus, image beyond C. Object at focus, image at infinity. And object between focus and pole, image behind the mirror. It is erect, it is virtual, and it is larger than the object. It is larger than the object. In the same way, convex mirror also, I'll show you. In the convex mirror, this is the convex mirror. Object is at infinity. Object at infinity. These rays are coming, striking the mirror, diverging back, and if we are bringing them backwards, image formed is at C. Image formed at its focal point. And image is small in size. It is virtual and erect. Image is smaller in size. This object is bigger. Image is smaller. It is virtual and erect. And if the object is placed at any point in front of the mirror, any point, it may be on pole, on center of curvature, any point on the principal axis in front of the mirror, the image will always be formed between pole and the focus point. Image will always be formed on the pole and focus point. And it will always be smaller than the object. It will be smaller than the object and virtual and erect. Image will always be virtual and erect. So we can say that a convex mirror always forms virtual and erect image, which is smaller than the object. So if we want to get a smaller image, we have to use a convex mirror. Now we'll study about uses of curved mirrors. We'll study about uses of curved mirrors. Curved mirrors have a wide use. Concave mirrors are used as reflectors in flashlights. It is used as reflectors in flashlights. What happens in flashlights? A tiny bulb is placed at the focus of the concave mirror so that it acts as a reflector. It sends a powerful beam of parallel light in front of the user to see the objects clearly. And this principle is used to get light through reflectors in torches, automobiles, headlights, searchlights. Doctor's head mirror works on the same principle. It is used to examine patient's body without hindering the field of view. In shaving mirror also it is used. For makeup mirror also it is used. And enlarged images formed when the object is kept between the focal length of the concave mirror. Enlarged images formed. And in satellite dishes also it is used. In reflecting telescopes it is used. It is also used by dentists and ENT doctors. Concave mirrors are used by dentists and ENT specialists during the examination procedure, as these mirrors form large images of teeth, ear, nose, etc. So we get a large image by using concave mirrors. So all these ENT and dentists use these concave mirror. In solar panels and solar furnaces also, and solar cooker also, all these things use concave mirrors to focus sunlight. Okay? It is used to focus the sunlight to produce large amount of heat. So in solar furnaces, the use of solar furnaces, solar cookers, solar heaters, all these, they make use of the solar energy. So by concentrating solar energy at a particular point, to focus it at a particular point to get a large amount of heat. Convex mirror. Convex mirror, as I've told you, convex mirror always gives a smaller virtual and erect image. So it is used as a rear view and side view mirror in vehicles. It is used as a rear view and side view mirrors in vehicles. The rear view and side view mirrors of a vehicle use these convex mirrors as it forms an upright and diminished image of the back view. The driver, the person who is driving the vehicle will get a diminished image of the smaller and upright image of the back view. And these mirrors also cover a wider field of view. They cover a wider field of view. Often on some these mirrors, sometimes it is written objects in mirrors are closer that they appear. It is also printed to warn the driver that image formed has distortion effects regarding distance perception. It is always also used as reflectors in street lights and to view larger areas or tall buildings. It is also used in malls, railway platforms, at sharp turns to easily look the wider view. So convex mirror has a wide use as a in rear view mirrors in shops, malls, railway platforms, hills where there are steep curves. Okay, because it is used because it forms a smaller real and smaller virtual and erect image. I hope image formation by concave and curves mirror is very clear to all of you. Thank you. Have a nice day. We'll continue.